Welcome everybody. In October 2007, Her Majesty the Queen, our boss, dedicated the Armed Forces Memorial. A year later, I stood on these same steps and said thank you to 2,000 people that attended the first ride to the wall. It was only supposed to be 200, but that's a different story. Why is Ride to the Wall so different and with us forever? Unfortunately, every year, names on the walls of the Armed Forces Memorial have a direct and immediate impact on possibly 2 to 3 generations going forward. At the same time, there are those that have in recent years lost loved ones. By coming together in our own unique way as a band of brothers and sisters, we are all here to support one another and remember. After 15 years, we're still here and growing. And this is down to all you here today who believe, understand, and embrace remembrance. In this ever-changing world that we find ourselves in, one thing that will never go away are the names on the walls of the Armed Forces Memorial. And it is our duty to make sure that we continue to remember them, and in doing so, educate those following, our children, to do the same. For this unique service of remembrance to take place, there's a tremendous amount of teamwork behind the scenes to pull it all together. These include the RTTW trustees and committee, and all the marshals and volunteers who work throughout the year, giving their time freely, which I for one am extremely grateful. There's also the staff at National Memorial Arboretum, supported this year by the staff from the Royal British Legion Festival of Remembrance team, the National Highways Agency, the M6 toll, and numerous police forces around the country, all coming together to make sure we can remember as safely, respectfully, and memorably as possible. Finally, a massive thank you goes out to each and every one of you here today for your support and the support you've shown for many years for Ride to the Wall. Let's hope we can be united again on the 7th of October next year as one to remember. Thank you.